Blog Talk Radio.
My Gospel Soul. Weekdays on Blog Talk Radio. Bringing you news, bringing you words of encouragement to brighten your day. Tune in or call in at 347-826-9424. We look forward to fellowshipping with you. My Gospel Soul, favorite statement. God favors me today. God honors me today. I am a success today. I have God's special favor on me today. He makes his face to shine upon me today. He is gracious to me today. I am someone very special with the Lord. I like people and they like me. I am flowing in God's love, and others are receiving healing, both in mind and body, through my life and ministry. I am growing in the Lord. I am waxing strong in spirit. I am growing in wisdom, and I have favor with God and man. I obtain favor in the sight of all who look upon me. I shall have favor today with people. I will meet nice people today. I shall have good relationships with people today. I shall favor and honor others today. I will be a blessing to the Lord. I will be a blessing to others. I am a person of prayer. God is bringing me into favor and success today. Confess favor with people, businesses, your family, friends, city, boss, and co-workers, and everyone you come in contact with. This has been My Gospel Soul's favorite statement. God bless.
Maybe then I can dance off the pavement. It's crazy how we only get higher at the peak, but I'm still so inspired.
I'm Jeremiah, a prospect to be a prophet. And I don't even want a prophet. Time to release, according to Miss Janice. Get up, move your feet, we're trying to reign peace.
Amen. You're listening to My Gospel Soul. Welcome to the show. Yesterday we had technical difficulties, so we could not be on the air. But we just thank God, amen, for another opportunity, amen, to share the gospel of Jesus Christ, to encourage you, amen. Hallelujah to be. Praise God, all that you could be in Him. Amen. So we're going to keep the show going. And when we come back, we're going to get into our weather. We'll do a sound check in just a few seconds. Praise God. But until then, this song is Father right here on My Gospel Soul.
People show what's the least.
Welcome back. It's none other than your host, Pastor Jay, coming to you live from Houston, Texas. To God be the glory for the great things that he has done. Amen. He makes his face to shine upon us and be gracious to us and to give us peace. Praise God. Amen. Welcome, welcome, welcome to another episode of My Gospel Soul. We're going to get into the weather. Amen. Let you know what's going on in Houston. Y'all know we've been dealing with a lot of rain. Okay, we just came out of Hurricane Beryl. I believe that's what his name was, a Beryl, whatever his name was. He wreaked havoc at a Category 1. So I'm hoping Houston is ready for a Category
poor. I hope that we can get it together, because the damage that was caused during Burrell, or whatever his name was, had the lights out, the power out for days. So we just want to send out special prayers to everyone. It's just raining here right now, but we definitely want to keep everybody lifted up in prayer, pray over everybody's person and their personal property. So today is, I know I'm in my weather, today is Thursday. The tip right now is at 70 degrees. Tonight it's going to be at 74. During the day, showers with a chance of thunderstorms late this morning. Then showers and thunderstorms likely in the afternoon. Highs around 80, southeast winds 5 to 10 miles per hour. The chance of rain is at 90%. Showers and thunderstorms likely on tonight. Lows in the lower 70s, east winds 5 to 10 miles per hour. The chance of rain is at 70%. For Friday, showers and thunderstorms likely. Humid with highs in the mid-80s, southeast winds 5 to 10 miles per hour. The chance of rain is at 70%. For Friday night, mostly cloudy, a chance of showers and thunderstorms after midnight. Humid with lows in the mid-70s, southeast winds 5 to 10 miles per hour. And the chance of rain is at 50%. You're listening to My Gospel Soul. We are breaking the yoke of bondage through the power of the word of God. Keep your mind stayed on him. Amen. And he'll keep on blessing you. He'll keep on making a way out of no way. This next song is He's Real right here on My Gospel Soul.
Your voice, sing a new song. Don't look back, this is where you belong. You see, time gets hard and things get wrong, but Jesus will take it right when you had it.
He's real.
Amen. He's real. He's real. Oh, yes, he is. We are at a place, again, here in Houston, amen, where we are just coming through a storm. Everybody is applying for FEMA and assistance. I'll tell everyone to call 211 if you are on SNAP. Call 211. Let them know that you lost your food. And some people that haven't done so, so I just want to encourage you to, if you need assistance, get assistance, okay? And then God set things in place to where you don't have to lag, okay? Amen. One of the topics, it was a video going around Instagram. I mean, it's still on Instagram. And it was about a woman who was shot dead in her home by police. And it's unrest in the Black community because we're seeing our children killed, our mothers killed, our fathers and our sons have been being killed, you know, by law enforcement. And a lot of times, as Christians, we don't say anything, we don't comment, or we don't say anything. But we need to speak up. We need to pray. We need to be in position to be a comfort to those that are suffering a loss, but also be the voice of change. And I just want to encourage you all to be a part of change. Be a voice of change. You are in the community. People come to the church. People acknowledge you. People. So let's get more involved as men and women of God. Amen. I want to say a prayer for her children. Her father. Her father. I saw him in a video talk saying they didn't kill the wrong girl. He's standing up for his daughter, and I love it because justice needs to prevail. And I believe, amen, that we serve a true and living God that will not let this go undealt with. And so we just want to pray for his family. Amen. As he walks as the covering, as the voice, amen, for his daughter and for the children that have been left behind. Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, we just pray. We pray right now over this family. We ask you, Father God, to just come on in, Father God, and be a strength right now while this father is grieving the loss of his daughter, Sonia. We ask you, Father God, that you just touch the Massey family right now, Father God. Amen. Touch them, Father God. Hallelujah. Strengthen this father. Amen. I don't see his name, but strengthen him, Father God, from the crown of his head to the sole of his feet. Hallelujah, Lord. Give him, Father God, continue to give him the wisdom and the courage to stand in this time, amen, in defense for his daughter. Lord, we have seen the video, Father God. We have seen it, and we need you, Father God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah to show yourself strong in this situation. Cover the children as they grieve, Father God. Lord, and just keep us, and we thank you for it right now. In your son Jesus' name. So I was reading, it says Sonia Massey's father speaks about being told conflicting stories about his daughter's death. He says, although the body cam footage was disturbing, he's grateful that it was released and Massey's family now knows the truth. And I believe that he was saying that he didn't, when they told him about it, they said it, like an intruder had killed his daughter. But when the video was released, he could see undoubtedly that it was a deputy involved.
It was a deputy that killed his daughter. So it says, as we previously reported, Sonya Massey was fatally shot by an Illinois police officer. After she called 911 to report a possible intruder in her home, recently released body cam footage shows the Illinois deputy asked her to remove a pot of boiling water from her stove to prevent a fire. Shortly after the deputy shot her and alleged she came at him with boiling water. So if you go to mygospelsoul.com, you can, I posted a couple of Instagram posts. I posted Stephanie Mills' Instagram post where she has posted the video. I posted Gail's interview with the Falk. So go to, again, to mygospelsoulmagazine.com or mygospelsoul.com so you can see that for yourself. We want to keep our family, this family, our families lifted up in prayer. We'll be right back. Welcome back. My Jesus is a joy to me. None other than your host, Pastor Jay. Amen. Love you. Praise God. Amen. I'm talking about Sonia Massey. And prayer, sending a prayer for her family and her father as he seeks justice for his daughter's murder. Now, we look at the Cam video, and we're thanking God that it's released. And you outright see, she said, and when she said it, it's like you knew she could see a spirit on this cop. Now the father, she said, I rebuke you. And the father did research on the cop and found out that the cop had some previous stuff on his record and should not have been still policing. Okay. And so when she called for help because she thought she had an intruder and she lost her life. So we really need to pray for our law enforcement. We need to really pray. We need to really get in a place where we understand that you cannot go to sleep on this matter. We have lost too many people, black people, African-American people, brown-skinned people to law enforcement brutality. And so I just need you all to pray. I'm going to be talking about the entire show. We'll go into some scriptures and encourage your spirit today as well. So just hang tight and we'll be right back.
I've been through so much in my life, tried everything, but nothing turned out right. Then the master, he took my hand. Now he's leading me to the promised land. For the Bible tells me.
Don't you wanna go? I know I do. You see, I got a mansion in heaven. I'm going home where my Savior is. Oh, yeah. That is where I want to live. I will wear a white.
Welcome back. It's none other than your host, Pastor Jay. Listen. Just encouraging you to get involved, even if it's just sharing. It's important. Now, you know, back in the day, we just had the news. You just heard about it on the news, and then you saw a protest. And that's how we could get involved. But now social media, we can get involved with social media. It's all kinds of ways now to get involved. So I want to encourage you to get involved in some type of way. Please share your opinions, how you feel about it. How would you feel if you got that call? I want you to just put yourself in his shoes, in that father's shoes. How would it go for you what would cross your mind? And then finding out that law enforcement actually killed your child. Because I need for you to understand why it's important that we support this father. I was having a conversation with my children about how being a black mom, being a mama of black boys, and now really just being a mom of black children, how It takes prayer. It takes faith. It takes telling your children the truth. It takes giving, imparting wisdom in your children in order to keep your children alive, because they are brown, because they are, and I know people say black, but we look at the skin tones and we are brown people. Hispanic people are brown people. Mexican people, brown people. Indian people, brown people. We are being killed. Okay? Okay? She calls people for help and she's killed. So we have to support, pray, you know, call our churches together to pray. And we can't go to sleep on this. We have to be intentional with our prayers, prayers of protection. Moms, get up in the morning, command the morning, wake your children up, go in their room, you know, wake them up and pray in their rooms. Pray over them. Call your daughters. Call your sons. Don't care what age they are. Pray over them. Pray over them. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. And pray for this father. We'll be right back. welcome back, welcome back. There's a name above any name, and that name is Jesus. Praise God. Amen. That name is Jesus. Amen. And we're at a time, praise God. Amen. When it's praying time. It's been beyond praying time. I know we say that a lot in church. It's praying time, but it's been praying time. Amen. And so I just want to say, make sure, amen, that you understand that. Glory to God. There's no time or no room to stop praying. Come on, amen. It's no time to stop praying. Amen. We gotta pray without ceasing. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. And my son right now is in the Marines. Praise God. Was supposed to come home October, but he texted me to say, "Mom, I they're extending me." Amen. And I'm just at a place, praise God, where I gotta pray. Hallelujah. Amen. I gotta pray. Amen. And they're not playing no games. You know, a lot of times you always saying, "Oh, I'm praying for you. I'm praying for you," but are you really? Amen. Are we really praying for each other? Amen. Are we really praying without ceasing? Are we really giving it to God? Hallelujah. Amen. And this is not to judge you. This is just to say, let's be about our business for real. Amen. And let's stop playing the games. Hallelujah. Amen. You want God to do some things for you in your life? Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. You want God to change some things. You want divine protection, praise God, from on high. Amen. Then guess what? Amen. You have to, praise God, be praying for real. Stop we go on Facebook, I praying for you, put praying hands. When it's easy just to take a moment and pray for people. Just take that moment, amen, and pray their strength in the Lord. Hallelujah. Because I'm telling you right now, it's not easy, praise God, when you are trying to raise African American children and at least get them to grow old. Our youth are not growing. They're not growing old. And I'm not even stopping at youth. I'm talking about fathers leaving home to go to work and never come home. I mean, get pulled over for a ticket, get shot, killed on the side of the street, it's just, it's beyond time to pray. It's beyond time to pray. And I'm hoping that somebody hear me right now. I hope that somebody right now in their spirit is saying, "Oh, this is my call. This is God is talking to me. God, come on. I'm listening. Come on." Because I'm telling you, it's a sad affair when we have a lot of people saying they praying and they're not. Amen. Pastor Dr. Hall, Sandra Hall, preached Sunday, "Follow the Leader." Amen. And I was listening to the sermon, very, very good sermon. But what caught me was when she said, "I'm going to say I'm praying for you." Are you praying? You know they're not praying for you, or either they scandalize you, We really need to use our powers for good. Amen. We lie, we backbite, we what this, that. Listen, there's no time for that. It's time to pray. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm talking about pray for real. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Don't cut no corners. Don't, this is intentional prayer. This is intercessory prayer. Though you don't know what intercessory prayer is, I need you to look it up. Amen. Hallelujah. Look it up. Glory to God. Amen. And allow God to teach you so you don't just be saying stuff. "Oh, I'm going to intercede." Amen. No, look it up. Praise God. So that you can know exactly what intercessory prayer is. It's when you hear people say, "I'm going to stand in the gap," or whatever, for somebody. That's what it means. Praise God. That you're going to stand in the pray with or for somebody who's going through some trials and tribulations. I was talking to a young lady, and I was teaching her about intercessory prayer because she dreams a lot. And like she says, sometimes during she wishes some of the stuff she sees, she wishes she had it that she didn't see. But I was telling her, I said, it's because you are an intercessor. Praise God. God gave you that gift so that you would be able, amen, to pray for somebody. Amen. God show you things before they happen so that you would pray. So you learn to pray. Amen. And intercede on their behalf. Not every time you dream something are you supposed to call that person and tell them. Amen. Sometimes you dream it, God will give it to you because you, amen, have a divine connection in intercessory prayer. Amen. So, amen, you are a sentimental person. You are a person that's in tune, amen, with emotions. And so your prayer, amen, hallelujah, is a sincere prayer. When you pray for someone, see, it's a lot of people who have this gift, but they, you know, they don't understand it. Amen. Why do I dream about people? Why do I dream about tragedy? Why do I see death before it happens? Why do I see when people are in trouble or doing things they have no business? It's not for you to gossip or call somebody and say, I had this dream so-and-so. No, it's for you to get on your knees and pray. It's for you to stand in the, and it could be a man or woman of God and you see sin in their life or you see temptation happening or you see the act of. So you, God uses you because he made you for this. Amen. He uses you to pray. Now, sometimes God will have you go warn that person. He'll have you, praise God, to go and say, listen, the Lord showed me blah, 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 blah. Or you don't have to tell me you dream that God, you'll say, hey, listen, I was shaking people's hands, and God will show me something or an overwhelming feeling will come over me and God will, you know, it's different ways that God has used me, praise God, and I have accepted, amen, that call, amen. It's not just a gift, it's a call, amen, hallelujah, amen, and you have to be obedient, and sometimes, amen, people will reject what you say and reject you after you say it, but I'm willing to be rejected, amen, to make sure that I deliver the message that God has called me to deliver. Amen. I'm going to tell y'all a secret too, praise God. And when you gift it like this, and you don't have very many friends. Amen. You don't get invited to a lot of stuff. Amen. And you're peculiar. Glory to God. In other words, praise God, folks don't understand you. Amen. And they ain't trying to. Amen. But don't get weary in well doing. You reap if you faint not. Keep on doing what God has called you to do. Amen. I mean, that's big and that's greater things, amen, that he has called you to do. Amen. Never be discouraged doing what God has called you to do. Amen. We're going to keep on with the show and keep going. And let's see what else I got. Praise God. I did a cover of Because of Who You Are. So we'll play that. Amen. We'll play that. Amen. And I want you to just think about what I've said. Amen. It's praying time, but also, amen, Holy Spirit, let me share with you what being an intercessor is and how heavy it is to carry that. But God has your back. Amen. God bless. We'll be right back.
gospel, but is it the truth? Judging people high and low out of self-righteousness. Jesus said, don't judge no one when your stuff is a mess. Live for real.
Live for real.
If there's a change in your life, you need to live for real.
Live it for real.
Live for real.
Live it for real.
If there's a change in your life, you need to live for real.
Live it for real.
While yours is in the clear. My God, he sits high and he looks low. You'll see more blessings when you hang up the phone. Live for real.
Live for real.
If there's a change in your life, you need to live for real.
Live it for real.
Live for real.
Live it for real.
If there's a change in your life, you need to live for real.
Live it for real.
I hear you talk about what Jesus did for you. Live it for real. Spread your gospel, but is it the truth? Live it for real. Change in your life, you need to live for real.
Live it for real.
Live for real.
Live for real.
If there's a change in your life, you need to live for real.
Live it for real.
Live for real. If there's a change in your life, you need to live for real. Live for real. If there's a change in your life, you need to live for real.
Live it for real.
Amen. Make your election sure. Hallelujah. Work out your own soul salvation. Praise God. If it's a change in your life, live it for real. Praise God. Amen. Be proud of. He said, if you be ashamed of me, he said, if you be ashamed of me, I'll be ashamed of you. Amen. God wants us, praise God, to acknowledge who he is, what he's done for us. Praise God. That we serve him. Amen. It'll surprise you how many people well, back in the day, didn't want to admit that they were living for God. So you have to really ask yourself, are you living for God? Amen. Hallelujah. Are you? Praise God. Amen. So I want to read, the battle is not with flesh and blood. Amen. I'm reading from Dr. Cindy Trim's book, Praise God, The Rules of Engagement, The Art of Strategic Prayer and Spiritual Warfare. It says, make note that in verse 12, amen, hallelujah. Let me give you the background before I get started. Verse 12, we are in Luke 15:11-32. It says, make note that in verse 12, the son demands a portion of his inheritance that was to be divided between him and his older brother after their father died. But the father gives his son what he asked for. Further down, we see that he quickly wasted his substance with riotous living. If you understand what it means to be a child of wealth and means, you will know that this son would have been reared in an environment where financial stewardship was paramount. The fact that he demanded his inheritance before time and squandered it foolishly tells us that something or someone got a hold of his thoughts.
telling him lies about what he deserved and that he shouldn't have to wait to receive what is due him. Good parents generally tell their children to be patient, to not grow up too fast, and to use their time and resources wisely. The son rebelled against everything that his father would have taught him up to that point. And that kind of rebellion is indicative of a demonic spirit at work. Spiritual warfare, in its purest form, is the counsel of the human mind by any other spirit other than the Spirit of the Lord. You must discern the spirit that is at work overtly and covertly. Ephesians 6 and 12 says, "For we wrestle not with flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rules of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places." It is obvious that the son is neither having a fight with his father, nor is anyone pushing him out of the nest before his time. There is an internal spiritual struggle that influences the son's actions, and giving into this struggle caused his demise. The same is true for us. Our warfare is not with human beings, but with the devil and his demons, who propagate doctrines of devils, heresies, Luciferian idolatry, satanic philosophies, and diabolical imagery. Our enemy, Satan, attempts to defeat us with strategy and deceit, through well-laid plans and deliberate deceptions and manipulations. When he speaks to our minds in an attempt to derail us from following a path that leads us to fulfillment of purpose and destiny, he never speaks to us in the second person. He uses first person, I, to deceive us into believing that the thoughts running through our minds are our thoughts and not suggestions, projections, prompting, or urges emanating from him. He begins with warfare strategies by bombarding our minds with a clever, devised pattern of little nagging thoughts, suspicions, doubts, fears, wonderings, reasoning, and theories. He moves slowly and cautiously, deliberately and patiently. He will never say, "You are sick, you are poor, you should leave your church, or you are never going to make it." He will say, "I am sick, I am leaving this church, I am never going to make it," because he really wants us to believe that the thoughts he placed in our minds are ours. I remember returning home one night. I'm reading from Dr. Cindy Trim's book, amen. I remember returning home one night after ministry. I sat on the edge of my bed, and all of a sudden, I felt sad. Thoughts started racing through my mind, and my internal dialogue was incredibly and unusually negative. Since I am basically a positive person, initially I dismissed it as fatigue. However, the thoughts became so overpowering that I began to entertain them as if they were mine. I wanted to leave the ministry, forget about everything and everyone. Then the Holy Spirit rose up in me and instructed me to fight against the thoughts. I took on a posture of prayer and spiritual warfare, commanding the spirit to go. After binding and loosing and releasing the spirit from its assignment, I heard a whoosh sound and felt a presence leave my bedroom through the window. The thoughts and emotions I claimed as mine were really spirits of depression, death, trying to abort my ministry, purpose, and destiny, and frustration. This is how deceptive the weapons of the enemy are. Remember, when spirits come, they come to give diabolical counsel to your mind, because this level of warfare is spiritual, not carnal. Amen. Hallelujah. And if you have the book, I'm reading on page 42 through 43. And the next portion, the mind is the greatest battlefield. And maybe I'll read that
next time. But I wanted to read that because it's true. Amen. The enemy operates in a manner, and y'all hear me say it a lot, that the enemy is wicked and he's cunning. And the enemy works through imagination. Amen. And so if he can build a story and he can make you believe that this is your true feelings and your true thoughts, and he will get around in there and play and manipulate and and orchestrate, and before you know it, you're completely out of your destiny. You're completely out of God's divine plan for your life. Amen. So I want you to be careful of thoughts that you entertain. Like she says, depression, negativity, all of these different things you know don't come from God. God is not a negative. God is not a negative speaking God. Amen. He wants the best for your life. Praise God. Amen. And you gotta think this too. When the enemy wants you separated from the blessings of God, he wants you separated from, amen, from your divine walk, amen. He wants you separated, amen, from, amen, the true calling on your life, praise God. I always tell people the enemy wants what he can't have, and that's what, and that's, amen, a chance to go into the kingdom of heaven. So what he does is he sets you on a destructive path. Since he know he can't go, he don't want you to go either. Amen. He doesn't want you to experience God either. So he plots and he plants thoughts in your mind that cause division and destruction and cause you, praise God, to not, amen, be, amen, in a place, amen, of productivity, praise God. He wants you stifled. He wants your growth stunted. Amen. He wants you in a place of rebellion. Amen. Glory to God, to destroy your authority. Amen. So I want you to be very, very careful with the thoughts that you entertain, praise God. And like this reads, praise God, the enemy does not come and say you, amen, and instruct you. He comes in the form, I am sick and tired. I am, and before you know it, you are walking in a place. I remember I was feeling discouraged. Amen. I was feeling discouraged. I had put together an event, and in that event, In that event, no one showed up for the event. And I knew God had told me to put it together. I knew that it was something that God had told me to do. And so when I had put it together, the enemy began to mess with my mind. Look, nobody showed up. Look at this. And so I didn't want to do it again. So I didn't do it. It was years. I said, I'm not going to participate in any of this stuff. I'm not going to be around these people. And I separated myself. And it wasn't a good thing for me to separate myself. But it was because the enemy saw me, and before you know it, I'm on a path that's outside of the will of God. I'm doing the bare minimum in ministry. Right? Just enough to say I'm still doing something, you know, and not understanding, okay, now you're operating in rebellion, not rebellion against your spiritual mother or anything like that, but rebellion against the call and that God had on my life. And so you have to be careful what you entertain. You have to learn to rebuke. You have to learn to cast out. You have to learn, praise God, amen, that when these defeating negative thoughts begin to bombard or come into your mind, it's the first one. So the first thought is when you have to know that the enemy has now tried to open up a door and come on in. That's how he comes on in. He just wants you to have one negative thought, and then boom, that door is open and he's coming in. Because the enemy, in order for him to even be in your life, it's something in your life that belongs to him, or something in your life that's a portal to him. So you have to think, okay, how did the devil get here? How did this
Because when things are manifesting in your life, manifesting means being made known. That means it was already there. There's something there that you know, that you allowed in order for this to manifest. Come on, amen. Was it loneliness, depression? Oh, I don't want to be by myself no more. Was it jealousy because you were seeing everybody else in relationships? Was it jealousy because you were seeing everybody else in going forward in ministry or look like they were moving fast? You have to figure out what it was, that door that opened, that allowed these other spirits to come in. Because when one spirit comes in, here comes he bringing at least 6-7 of his friends. You know, because you'll be depressed, but then you'll be bitter. It'll be coupled with a couple of things. So you have to figure out, okay, where did I become negative, or what was the door? So that you close that door, you can rebuke, you can bind it up. Come on, cancel contracts. Come on, cancel assignments of the enemy on your life, and then you can get back, amen, in the righteous plan of God, amen. Hallelujah. So I hope that bless you. I hope that bless you, and I hope that I said something that could help you understand some things. Depression is not of God. Amen. Depression is an attack of the enemy on your life, on your self-esteem, on your divine calling. Amen. And you have to be able to identify it. And once you can identify it, you have to call it out. Amen. You have to send it back to hell from which it came. Amen. Then you have to step over it and keep moving forward. Amen. The worst thing you could do for in the devil's eyes, the worst thing you do is ignore him and keep it moving, rebuke him and keep it moving. Because he does not like that. He doesn't like it. Come on. He wants to set you up for failure. He don't mind you being a little productive if you got this area over here that's full of sin and full of. Look, let me tell y'all something. I was preaching the gospel and coming home and depressed. I was doing crusades and coming home and depressed with low self-esteem. And when you're depressed, got low self-esteem, low self-worth, guess what? All types of stuff will get invited into your life. I always tell people, don't say what you won't do if sin is present in your life. Because some people say, I probably did that sin, but I won't do that sin. You look at other people. But let me tell you something. Sin is sin. You can't say what you won't do. And when you open up the door to the enemy, you give him that type of power or that type of you give him power. I said that right. I'm going to repeat that. You give him, amen, space to come in. And like I tell people, put his seat on your coffee table and knock over it. Go all in your refrigerator. But just be aware, praise God. Govern your mind, praise God, amen. Pray every morning, Lord, I bring my thoughts and my mind under captivity to the Holy Spirit. Come on, glory to God. Lord, every negative thought, come on, I cast it down. Every negative plot, I cast it down. And you have to be careful, too. Before I let you go, but you have to be careful too what you say out of your mouth. Amen. Glory to God. Because if you speak it, it has a right to exist. If you speak it, it has a right to exist. If you speak that I'm going through it, if it ain't one thing, it's another, that's going to manifest. If you speak, I just can't get a leg up, I just can't do this and I just can't do that. And guess what? You are speaking those barriers into your life. That's why the enemy has you saying I this and I that, because he understands the power of the tongue. The word of God says the tongue is a ready writer. Amen. So what you say is being it's like writing it down. And once it's written down, it has the right to exist. I gotta help somebody. The devil is the prince of the air. Amen. So when you speak it out into the air, guess what? It has to manifest. Amen. So cast down. Cast it down. Amen. You can think of some things right now that have plagued your life and you can remember the time that you spoke it, come on, cast it down. Amen. Cast down everything that the enemy, praise God, has set up against you. Amen. And I promise you, you will see a turnaround. Amen. Pray without ceasing. Get up at 3 o'clock in the morning. 3 o'clock, 6 o'clock. Amen. And command your morning, praise God, to be subject to miracles and blessings, subject to the power of God. Amen. Hallelujah. No limit. Amen. Through. Amen. God. Amen. Speak over your day that it will be full of blessings. Praise God. Amen. That doors will open that no man can shut, and doors that are not for you will close. Amen. And no man can open it. And we thank God for it right now in the mighty name of Jesus. I love you all. Praise God. I want you to stay encouraged. Praise God. Amen. And pray for me, glory to God, amen. As I seek his face, praise God, to stay consistent. God bless you, and we'll, oh yeah, and remember, without faith is impossible, please God, but with God, all things are possible. Who cares? God cares.
My Gospel Soul, weekdays on Blog Talk Radio, bringing you news, bringing you words of encouragement to brighten your day. Tune in or call in at 347-826-9424. We look forward to fellowshipping with you.